Number 5.
Jiram jivan tuno nyati.
Yetang
hetu labhamase. Amma kancha katta puja. Dāyakācya anipphalā. Chiraṁ jīvaṁ suno nyāti. Yetāṁ hetu labhāmase. Amma kañca kattā pūjā. Dāyakācya anipphalā.
In return, such spirits thus remembered and satisfied will eagerly wish for the well-being of their living relatives, our gratitude. I think this must be out of gratitude, not hour of gratitude. Those fruit readers are responsible for this mistake. Not hour of gratitude. In return, that means when we transfer the merits, in return, those departed who are in the spirit form wish and express their happiness because they were released. The relief that they gained through the influence of our merits, they had the chance to get rid of that miserable state, then they express their happiness. Then they can have another rebirth, because still there are many more merits, had no chance to come forward. So then say, Chiranjivantu no nyati, me, our relative, live long, Chiranjivantu. This is their blessing in return. There is a story. One day, King Bimbisara, I think, invited the Buddha and his disciples, the monks, to his palace for dana. After offering this dana to the Buddha and the Sangha, the Buddha also gave a sermon and returned to the monastery. That night, the king could not sleep. The whole night, all sort of disturbances. Then he heard a sound. Could not understand anything. Now he is in fear, could not understand what to do, so he went to see the Buddha again and told him what happened last night. Then the Buddha, so some of his relatives who were the spirit poor, who are suffering due to certain bad karma that they have committed, they were waiting to receive the merits, transference of merits. But the king did not do that. So they were very unhappy. To express their unhappiness, they have created these disturbances. The next day, Again he invited the Buddha and the disciples to offer dana, then transfer the merit to the departed one. Then they had the chance to get rid of this miserable, unfortunate state. This is what happened during the Buddha's time. Number 6.
Nahi tat kasiyati. Gorakhetanavijyati. Vanijyata disinati. Iranyena kaya kayam. Ito dindena ya penti. Peta kala patatahin. Kasiyati gorakhetana vijyati vanijyata disinati hiranyena payakayam ito dinnena vyapinti peta kala katatahin.
For there is never loving here, nor any cattle herding farm, no merchandising just as the same, no bartering for coins of gold. The spirit of the departed king live there on the merits transferred to them. Now we can understand why they need merits. Because they cannot do anything in this spirit form. No cultivation, no pedigree, no vegetable, and no cattle, no animal life, and no business, no share market. Nothing. Therefore they are called Paradatta Upajivi. Pali word. Paradatta Upajivi. Live depending on others. Paradatta, given by others. Upajivi means live. So their life depends on the merit that we transfer. For them to get rid of this, not for their survival. They don't want to survive that form. What they want is to get rid of this. But others we cannot release because their karmas are very strong. We cannot shake them. But this particular group we can release. Since there is nothing that they can do, and their physical body is invisible to our naked eyes, and so tender, they cannot do any work. A spirit cannot take this and put here, no strength. Only we can do this. Animals can do this, but not spirit. Number 7.
Unname udakam vattam.
Unname udakam vattam.
Yathani minnam pavattati. Eva meva ito dinnam. Upakappati. Unna me udakam vattam yatha ninnam pavattati. Eva meva ito dinnam vetanam upakappati.
As water showered from the hill flow down to reach the hollow veil, so the merit transfer can serve the spirit of the departed king. This recitals also you can hear always the monks recite to transfer the merit. Unname udakan vattang yatha ninnang pavattati. The water showered on the hill flow down to reach the hollow veil. The water come down from the hill and go down and go. In the same way, that is why they use a water pot and a cup to pour water into this cup. This water, when we pour into this one and into the container or the cup, the water is just like merit, and this empty cup is just like the spirit. Receive the merit. And the cup that the water contains is just like our mind that we transfer. This is a symbolic expression of transference of merit. So it does not mean that without pouring water we cannot transfer the merit. Those who cannot understand, this is a symbol to show, just an illustration. But without pouring water we can transfer the merit. And I have seen, you see how poor our understanding is. When two families give dana, they bring two cups and two water pots. They think they should not touch the other person's pouring water. Very poor mentality sometimes we have. If we do jointly, we can increase more merit. If you are doing individually or separately, when we do some merit jointly, then our mental relationship, our understanding, our communication, our goodwill increase the merit. Then we encourage each other to do some more meritorious deeds instead of doing individually or privately.
Number 8. Yatha varivaha pura. Paripurenti sagaram. Eva meva ito dinnam. Petanam upakappati. Yatha varivaha pura paripurenti sagaram. Eva meva ito dinnam petanam upakappati.
These recitals also you can hear always the monks recite to transfer the merit. As river bed when full can bear the water down to the sea, so the merit transferred can serve the spirit of the departed king. rainy days, when the rivers overflow, and this water flow into the sea. In the same manner, when we have enough merit, when our minds are overflowing with merit, our mental, what you call, process, then we can easily transfer the merit to all our departed, just like river flow water into the sea. And the sea can absorb any amount of water. So these are simple examples that we can use to understand the meaning of transference of merit. Some people say it is only a traditional belief, whether there is any significance or whether it is useful or not. If they are useless or meaningless, the Buddha never uttered these words. And our own experience also, how certain disturbances that we had managed to stop after transferring merits to our departed, and how certain bad dreams that we had also no more after transferring merits, and certain smell, bad smell, and very intolerable eerie sound. Sometimes the experience also can get rid of this. Here, in this temple, about 40 years ago, we had only very old house here, wooden house, shrine room, also very small, that's all, and the preaching hall here. We were staying in this building. And preaching and teaching and eating and sleeping and everything here in that small preaching hall. But night time, by this time, when you go out about that area or this area, very funny, very filthy a smell. One moment the smell is here, next moment the smell is there. And the next moment a smell is near the gate, and again a smell is here. We purposely walk and see where the smell is. Remained for nearly 1 year. And there's another reverend here, both of us. Then we built that house, which we renovated into a two-story building in 1953. So the opening ceremony, we organized, we wanted to have all-night chanting, first time in the history of this temple. We had only 5 monks, 2 from Penang, 1 from Singapore, and 2 from here. So we had all-night chanting. After that all-night chanting, that smell completely disappeared. Then we got the news, many years ago, this is nearly 100 years old temple, an old man who was staying in this temple died here. That's all. And after this old man chanting, that smell also disappeared. Now these are our own experience. So we should not say, I think all rubbish and everything. Should not be so skeptical at once, you know, and too smart also to say all rubbish. I think better to stop here. Yeah, number 8. Yeah. Next Friday. Now you want to know about the 11th kind of fire, isn't it? Rāgocca dosocca mohocca vyādi jarācca marana vicca sokame parideva dukkhan picha dhomanasan upayasa ekadasa means 11. In the Pali language, this is the way how they count. Eka means 1, dasa means 10. 1 and 10, 11. This is the ancient language, this is how they count. Eka dasa. 12, dva dasa. Dva means 2, dasa means 10. 2 and 10, 12. This is a Malay, orang orang, plural. All languages are like that. Yes. Raga, lust, craving for sex, birth whole body and mind both, and go mad, and can kill others, and kill themselves, when they are mad with that lust, the sexual urge, even animals, how they fight and bite, and humans, they go mad, they can do any dirty or immoral or wicked thing, is a real fire, burn the whole body, burn our mind, and destroy our life. And destroy others' life. That is why religion always advises to reduce and calm that mind. Don't be crazy. Otherwise you spoil your life. That is the first one. Second one is dosa. Dosa in Malay language gives another meaning, not anger, anything. The Pali, sin, of course, it is a sin. And Pali dosa means hatred or anger. But really, burning, shivering, very fierce, when we are angry, when we have hatred. So we cannot see things properly when we are angry. We lose our reasoning, no sense of reasoning at that time. We cannot think unbiasedly, always biased. Then, whatever we talk, very rough and tough, and hurting, disturbing others. And our face also become very sour, very fierce, because the fire completely changed. And the complexion, the skin, the color of the skin also changed, reddish color, the blood. And those who suffer from high blood pressure get blood clot, or hemorrhage, brain hemorrhage. How many people died because of that anger? Those who suffer from high blood pressure. Who suffer? Increase the pressure. Or a stroke, collapse. So it is a real fire, this anger. Then moha. Moha means cover. That is ignorance. Ignorance covers the lens of our mind. Then we cannot see things properly. We create fear or imagination. If not, cannot understand anything. Later, this moha, this ignorance, endanger or disturb our life. Because the wrong idea that we have created, then we create enemies. we disturb others, we suspect others, ruin our life. So ignorance also regarded as a fire, which ruins our life. Next one is vyadhi. Vyadhi means sickness. When we suffer from sicknesses, ache and pain and worries and disturbances, unpleasant mental attitude that we maintain. Therefore, sicknesses also regarded as fire. And burning sensation itself is a sickness. That is fire. Gastric trouble. Fire. We feel in the stomach we have fire. I experience this if I take a little bit of acid or vinegar or chilies. The whole day, and whole 5 kg, you know, burning and burning and burning, no cure. Then take tablet and tablet and tablet to satisfy, because extra the acid is accumulate in the stomach, not burning the skin of the stomach. That is fire. That sickness is fire. Jara. Decay, old age, it is a fire. The way how they suffer, when they attain certain, that body, that life become nuisance, burdens to himself or herself and to others. Worse than fire. Fire burns at once and finish, but this one remains for many years, torturing and torturing and disturbing and disturbing and creating worries and so many other disappointments. It is fire. That is why the Buddha always say, existence creates suffering. We are not ready to accept this. We try to patch up here and there, and try to maintain. But how long can you carry on? Next one, marana. I think this word you know very well, marana. What is marana? Death. When we think of this, the burning, the whole body, because we don't want to die. We don't want to die because of our craving. When we think that one day we have to die, then burning. We don't want to die. When the death comes to us, then we cry, we worry. Then others also cry because of our death. So death is another kind of fire. After death, again, fire is needed for burning, cremation. Then come to the mental side. This is physical. Soka, parideva, dukkha, domanasa, upaya. The 5 kinds of suffering, mental. Worries, burn whole body and the mind. Lamentation and mental disturbances. And thinking that something will happen to us, unfortunate thing. Then go on thinking and thinking and worrying and disturbing our mind, happiness completely disappears from the mind. So, mind has no peace, no satisfaction in our life. Whole day and night, go on thinking and worrying and crying and blaming and accusing and disturbing others also. By considering this physical and mental attitude, mind and matter here, these two things, every second create disturbances because of clash. Elements and elements clash here in the physical body. Energies and energies, energies and elements again clash. So this is a battlefield. This whole body is a big battlefield. Not only elements and energies, again bacteria, virus, germs, they also attack. Then cells in our blood, white and red, and these two also fight, then create sickness. Then the brain cells, neurons, disturbances, imbalance. So now you can understand. The other day I told you, this is actually a dustbin. We carry this as most precious, valuable. Open and see what is inside. What a beautiful thing inside. We covered everything with nice dress and apply all sorts of things, beautify, wonderful. Open and see what it is. For our own particle of this body, we put out our own, not others. This is the nature, this fact. We work just like a self-hypocrite, you know, without realizing, without admitting, without understanding real nature. Then we know how to make use of this life, this body, without misusing to harm, to disturb, to block others for our living. Then slowly we can get into religious way of life, to live, to satisfy, not to worry, not to cry, by realizing this is the situation, this is the nature. These are the 11 kinds of physical and mental.
Adasime, akasime. Nyati mitta sakkhacchami. Cetanam dakkhinam dajjā. Ubbe katta manussaraṁ. Adāsime asāsime jñāti mittā sakkhācchami. Cetanam dakkhinam dajjā. Ubbe katta manussaraṁ. He gives to me, he works for me, he was my kin, friend, intimate. Give gifts, then, oh, departed ones recalling what they used to do, how they enjoyed. After receiving our merit, when they feel some sort of relief because of our marriage, and what they say, Adasini Akasini, oh, they have done something for us, they have given something for us, marriage. Jati Mitta, that's why I told you, Jati means relative, Mitta means friend. Our friends, our relatives, Jati Mitta, Sakha also, beloved one, those who love. They have done something for us. They have transferred the merit to us. Etanang dakkhinang dajya. So they have given dakkhina. The word dakkhina we can interpret in two ways. By offering food or anything also we can interpret as dakkhina. Transference of merit also we can interpret as dakkhina. So our relatives have given us dakkhina, something. Buddhe kata manusvaran, recalling what they used to do. So they remember, they appreciate, they feel very happy. In fact, they bless in return. So the meaningfulness of transference of marriage. So in every religion there is some sort of religious services for the departed. In Hinduism also, before Buddhism came into existence in India, they had offering of food. They go to the river Ganges, regarded as a holy river, carry food and do some offering and recite some mantra for their departed ones. Because they, after burning the dead body, the ashes they throw into this river. That river is very famous for that. Because they believe when they throw this into the river, straight away go to the, what you call, Ishwara, the God. This traditional belief in India. Although the Buddha did not accept this belief, he introduced very practical and rational and reasonable method to transfer the marriage. In Christianity and Islam, of course, pray to God. And Buddhism, by doing some meritorious deeds, transfer the marriage not through the God, not through the agency. Directly we try to approach our departed one. Number 10.
Nahirunnangasokova. Ye chanye paridevana.
This must be ya, not ye.
Ya chanya paridevana. Natte nata peta na mataya. Evang tithanti nyatayo. Nahi runnang rasokova yachanya paridevana natapetana mattaya evantittanti nyatayo.
No weeping, no yet sorrowing. No any kind of mourning. Help the departed ones whose skin remain acting thus, unhelpful to them. This one we have already discussed. by worrying or crying or lamenting or mourning for our departed ones, we cannot do any service to them. Just only express our emotional feeling or our attachment towards them. And when we cannot control our emotional feeling or attachment, naturally, we cry and we worry and we lament and we do something. Mourning, just last Friday also I explained, we indicate something, some external gadget to tell others that we are mourning. But here, mourning does not mean that external gadget, only in the mind. That we, during that period, either 3 months or some people take for 1 year, they do not organize weddings or marriages. They do not organize any parties or to enjoy. They do not organize feasts by inviting friends and relatives. Any celebration. In fact, certain food also they do not cook during that period. And this is called mourning period. But in different countries they have different methods. I remember in Sri Lanka for nearly 1 year, they do not perform any marriage ceremony for 1 year. And no enjoyment. Because of the feeling they have. And they do not attend even certain function outside. This real inner feeling. From others, just only show piece of cloth here, dark color, for others to understand. Now this is a mourning period. Somebody died in our family, so that outsiders or friends or relatives do not disturb them or invite them to attend certain functions. And they also feel it is not nice for them to attend certain functions during this mourning period. Number 11.
Ayaṁ ca ko dakkhinā dinnā. Saṅghaṁ hi supatittitā. Dīgarattaṁ hitāyassa. Manaso upakappati. Ayaṁ ca ko dakkhinā dinnā. Saṅghaṁ hi supatittitā. Dīgarattaṁ hitāyassa. Manaso upakappati.
But when this offering is given to those members of the Holy Order, then it can serve them long in future and at once as well. So this is the only way that we can help. By performing this dakkhina, this word we can find even in India today, dakkhina. So Hindus, they invite Brahmins Brahmins mean Hindu priest. And offer food. That is called Dakshina, for they are departed. And the Buddhists also repeat, follow the same method by inviting monks for food in the name of their departed. That is called Dakshina. But for ordinary dana, they don't use the word Dakshina. It is dana. But for this particular offering of food, it is called Dakshina, in the name of the departed. The food or the gift that we offer in the name of the departed is called Dakshina. So when this Dakshina is given, the merit accrued by the givers, the relatives, of course, Hindu concept of transference of merit is not like Buddhist concept. By offering this, by performing these rites or ritual, they pray to God. And praying to God to release their relatives who are in the suffering state. And Buddhist concept of transference of merit is not requesting God to release them, but to direct mental communication to receive the merit. So different aspects. But the action is the same. Number 12.
So jati dhammo ca ayam nidassito. Etana puja ca kata ulara. Balanca bhikkhuna manu. Dinnam tumhi punyam pasutam anappakam sojati dhammo ca ayam nidassito. Vetana puja ca kata ulara. Balam ca bhikkhuna manuppa dinnam. Tummehi punyam pasutam anappakam.
By offering alms to the holy order in memory of the departed, the true path of action for relatives has thus been shown, and how high honor to departed ones is done, and how the holy order can be given sustenance as well, and how great merits can be stored away by you. There are four things here. By offering this dakshina or dana, we perform four kinds of duties. First thing is, so jati dhammo ca ayam nidassito. We have shown a very good example to others that we have done our duty towards our departed ones. By performing this kind of religious service, then others also learn from you. Your children, your friends outsiders. So you have shown a very good example to others. You have not neglected, not forgotten your relatives after they are dead. Now that is the first thing. Jnati Dhamma, your duties towards your jnati, your relatives. You have shown this, or you have done. Petana puja cha kata ulara. The second duty is, you have supported, you have helped, assisted your departed ones, those who are in suffering state or very uncertain state or very miserable state, for them to get rid of their unfortunate situation. Now that is the second duty. First, you have shown a good example to others. You have not forgotten your departed. Those who were living, who have done a lot for you. Or whether they have done anything for you or not, since they are related to you, you do something for them. Second thing, after receiving the merit, when they are benefited, when they were released from their miserable situation, you have fulfilled the second duties. You have done something for them to get rid of that unfortunate state. Balancha bhikkhuna manuppadinnam, third duty. By offering this food to religious people, who have dedicated their life to serve others, to guide others, to educate others. By leading a religious way of life, a noble life, harmless life, you supported them to sustain, to maintain their life, to carry on their noble work. So those monks or those religious people, after taking your food, they gain ayu, vanna, sukha, bala, four kinds of energies. You offer these four kinds of energies to these monks, for them to live long because of your food. One, complexion. Without proper food or vitamins or suitable food, they cannot maintain their human body. Then they can lead a comfortable, peaceful life without suffering due to lack of vitamin or lack of food. Then they gain more energy to do their work, stamina, to carry on their work. So you offer four kinds of energies to those monks with your food. Then they can carry on their work. Those who preach, those who teach, those who meditate, those who do some welfare work for the benefit of others. And there are various ways for religious people to serve others, to serve the public. But all these activities, they can do well after taking your food that you offer. Now that is the third one. See how meaningful. Last one is, Tumhehi punyam pasutam anappakam. You also gain lot of merits. Not only given to others, you also gain something. The merit that we gain by performing some religious services, we transfer to others. Some people ask, what about us?
When you transfer the merit to others, they have nothing for us. But they do not know, transference of merits is another kind of merit over here. We multiply, we increase our merits more by transferring merits. Now if we keep to ourselves without transferring merits, it can be very limited merit. But when we invite others to share the merit, increase again. You invite your friends and relatives, living ones. You mention today you have done this kind of meritorious deed. When they say, sadhu, very good, then increase, you gain more happiness. They encourage you to carry on, do more and more, then increase. Again, you invite devas and others to share the merit. You get, in return, their protection. You invite your departed ones to receive the merit. Again, you increase your merit. So the transference of merit is another kind of meritorious deed. So you gain a lot of merits. And these merits are important for you. You also need long life, healthy life, or wealthy life, peaceful life, happy and prosperous life, your protection, so many things. All these things we gain through the influence of our merits that we have done. So when we see the world, we can see why millions of others are suffering without food and clothing and shelter and medicines because they have not done enough merits. So they suffer. But when you compare our life with them, we can understand that definitely we have done some merits. Otherwise, we never get the chance to lead some sort of life where we can satisfy when compared with others. So these facilities, privileges, opportunities, we won't get very easily. To be born in certain countries, certain areas, where we can lead our life without facing so much problems and disturbances and suffering. We are fortunate in that respect, compared with others. And to lead a life without facing so many kinds of sicknesses, so many disturbances and miseries and worries, almost every day crying and worrying and fear and various other disturbances. But we are not that bad, although we have some disturbances and worries. Today we cry, next day we can laugh. But many others cannot. They have no chance to laugh. All the while crying and worrying and maintain fear and disturbances. So the merits are important for us to carry on our life. But we have to do this again and again. That is the problem. Once we have done some good merits, enjoy all the good results, after that nothing. Again, we have to do that. So these are the four things. So jnati dhammo cha ayam nidassito. We have shown a very good example to others how to respect or how to remember, how to pay our gratitude to our departed one who have done something for us. Then we have supported them to get rid of their sufferings and worries and fear.
By doing all these things, you also gain some merit. Then you feel happy. You can satisfy by thinking, I have done all my duties. And the merit that you gain support you to lead a peaceful life without facing so many disturbances and suffering. These things are real facts when you study